Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing the full team building guide of L.R. Bardock. And we have him over here, Father of Kakarot Bardock. So this is going to be the SSR, TUR, and LR overview. All their information. We're going to talk about the team building guide, the best linking buddies for pure Saiyans, one for low class warrior race, and the other for mono physical. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So Father of Kakarot Bardock. Leader ability originally, super physical type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 70%, extreme type key plus 1, HP attack and defense plus 50%. His super attack is a final spear cannon doing supreme damage to the enemy, passive skill up to the stars, attack and defense plus 50% at the start of the turn, an additional attack plus 20% when performing a super attack, key plus 2 when facing one enemy, and defense plus 40% when facing two or more enemies. Link skills are Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Lineage, Team Bardock, Saiyan Pride, and Prepare for Battle. Now, in terms of his linking abilities, Saiyan Warrior Race is kind of throwaway. Saiyan Lineage, Team Bardock, and Prepared for Battle, all key links. So that's all he really has is key links. The only real attack link that he has is Saiyan Pride for attack plus 15%. So keep that in mind. You're going to really need Saiyan Pride units when talking about this unit in the future for team building and everything like that. Even before I talk about it, like the actual team building guides, note that you need Saiyan Pride. So if you are actually looking to find out what units have Saiyan Pride, other than looking in-game, go ahead, check out the wiki, and click on Saiyan Pride, or type on Saiyan Pride in the search bar, and you will find out a whole bunch of them. By the way, shout out to the wiki, shout out to DokkanBattleBuilder.com. Thank you for all the help with this. Link skills, categories are low-class warrior and pure Saiyans. Max stats are HP of 6153, attack of 8708, and defense of 4699. He has a 12 key multiplier of 140%. Now, Bardock is a cool unit. I'm a big fan of Bardock. If you've been following me, you know I am a big fan of Bardock. The one thing about Bardock, though, unfortunately, he doesn't really have a farmable super attack. He had this star-crossed fate Bardock that came during the last battle. I have no idea when this is coming again. I'm gonna say that even if he does come, if it does come again, it's a rare. You're feeding a rare into an SSR. That is a 1% chance to increase the super attack. There is no category to buff the drops. The drops are going to be from level 6, the last battle. So, technically, he is farmable. But at a 1% rate, you are going to have to farm out hundreds, and I mean that, hundreds, of that Bardock. So, unless you're really, really free to play and you don't have the Elder Kais, I'm going to say use Elder Kais on this guy. He's going to Dokkan Awaken, though, Metals. I shouldn't have closed out of that. From that event, you're going to have to actually get the last battle of Bardock event. You're going to have to get, what is this, one of each? Yeah, you need one Tora, Shugesh, Fasha, and Borges. And once you get those, you'll be able to Dokkan them. Those are, again, from this event over here. The last battle, Lone Warrior's last battle. You have Shugesh is going to be on level 1. That's going to be on, I think that's easy. And then Z-Hard is going, you're going to be able to get Fasha, Borges, and Shugesh. You have Tora that's going to be available from level 3, and that's really it in terms of that. So pretty much everything's going to be available on level 1, and then you can get the rest on level 3. Me, personally, I ended up grinding out a whole bunch of them by accident just because I didn't realize that I was doing it. So that was a little fun for me, so I already have them set up for my Bardock. When you grind him out and Dokkan Awaken him, he becomes a doomed future Bardock. New leader ability is super physical type key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 90%, and extreme physical type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 60%. His new super attack is Final Spear Cannon, supreme damage to enemy, and raises attack for one turn. Passive skill, resisting the future, attack and defense plus 60% at the start of the turn. An additional 20% attack when performing a super attack, key plus 3 when facing one enemy, and defense plus 50% when facing two or more enemies. Link skills are Saiyan Warrior Race, the Saiyan Lineage, Team Bardock, Saiyan Pride, Prepared for Battle, and Shattering Limit. So he only gained one more link skill, and it was a key link skill. Shattering the Limit, so that way he has more key. Again, Saiyan Pride, the only thing you're going to be looking for an attack buff. He still has the same categories, low-class warrior and pure Saiyans. Max stats are HP of 7231, attack of 9748, and defense of 5513. 12 key multiplier, 145%, and raises attack for one turn is a 30% attack to the super attack multiplier. He will Dokkan Awaken. He requires 21 event medals from his Bardock event. Three of these Frieza medals, and actually it's funny, it looks like he requires the Prime Battle medals from the Frieza events. So this is going to be available, the actual Bardock medals are going to be available here. from the Ultimate Awakening in the history. We're going to have to go over and do that event three times. The last warrior again, lone warrior battle again, you're going to have to go ahead and go over into here, grab the Frieza medals. Frieza medals are going to be available on stage 6, last battle. And then it looks like over here, Awakening medals, Warrior's Mark Frieza, first form. It's going to be from the Summon of the Universe. It's the Prime Battle, the Frieza Prime Battle. It looks like you're going to have to get one of each. You're going to have to do level 2 and level 3 in order to Dokkan Awaken him. You're going to need 3 medals from, it looks like, the Warrior's Mark, Frieza's first form, and 35 of the other one. Let's see, which one is which, actually, because that's definitely going to make life a lot easier to know. It looks like you're going to need the one with the mouth open. Let's go over here. The one with the mouth open, you need 3 of them, so that's going to be a little bit easier. And then the last one, you need 35 of them, and he gets a lot of drops of those. So it's not going to be too bad to do that. When he Dokkan Awakens, he will Dokkan Awaken into Shining Life in the Cosmos, Bardock. I'm going to go ahead and close out of the other tabs here as well, because that was really annoying. He is a leader ability, super physical type, key plus 4, HP, attack, and defense plus 100%. Extreme physical, key plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 70%. Super attack, final spear cannon from 12 to 17 key, and Saiyan spirit 18 key or more. His final spear cannon greatly raises attack for one turn, causes colossal damage to the enemy, and Saiyan spirit mega colossal to the enemy and seals super attacks. Now, the one thing about this is his secondary Saiyan spirit 18 plus, he doesn't give himself an additional attack buff, but he does seal. Problem that I have with that is, why are we sealing super attacks when majority of Dokkan exclusives or Dokkan events cannot be sealed? I mean, maybe the first one or two rounds can be sealed, but it doesn't matter. I feel like he's going to be like the Majin Vegeta of LRs as well for the physical type. Because if you remember, Majin Vegeta does more damage when he has 17 ki. It looks like this Bardock, we're going to have to use 17 ki in order to get the best damage output from him. Even though Mega Colossal has a better multiplier, greatly raises attack for one turn, is definitely going to be a little bit more damage output, at least in my opinion. I haven't done the math on that, so if you know the math, go ahead and check it out. I will go and check the Reddit one for that information as well. Maybe I'll talk about it in another video. But a 17 key looks like it's going to be the best way to do the most damage output. I'm not saying that 18 keys isn't bad, just keep that in mind when you're trying to do some damage. Sealing super attacks is still good, especially if you're not doing a Dokkan Fest exclusive or doing a Dokkan event that he cannot be sealed, because sealing people is amazing. And if you're running a double LR Bardock team, it's always going to happen. And, hint, hint, spoiler here, some of his best linking buddies are the other Super Saiyan Bardock, which pretty much, except for the strength one, all of them seal. So there's going to be a lot of people who will never get super attacks off because of that. His passive skill is Changing Fate, attack and defense plus 70% at the start of the turn. An additional attack plus 30% when performing an ultimate super attack. Key plus 4 when facing one enemy, and defense plus 60% when facing two or more enemies. So that's not bad. He's going to be tanking a little bit better. Key plus 4, you're thinking, if you just say you have the friends, you're going to have 8 key. That's going to be 12 key starting out, so you're always going to have 12 key, assuming you have an LR Bardock friend to bring with you. If not, it's going to be probably 11 key, because you're probably going to have like a Super Gotenks or something like that. So keep that in mind. Link skills are going to be Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Lineage, Team Bardock, Saiyan Pride, Prepared for Battle, Shattering Limit, and Legendary Power. Unfortunately, he didn't get Fierce Battle, even though you're using some medals from the event. I'm a little bit upset about that. I think he needs another attack buff. I think that would be great. Legendary Power is cool and everything, but it's only attack plus 5,000, which at the end of the day, it's not as great as it could be. I mean, Saiyan Pride's awesome, but it's only a 15% buff. So overall, other than Legendary Power, which is still a decent 5,000 attack buff, 5,000 flat-out attack buff, he doesn't have any other percentage buffs. His categories are still the same, low-class warrior and pure Saiyans. Max stats are HP of 13,713, attack of 16,295, and defense of 10,400. One thing I can say about this unit, though, they didn't do him dirty on the attack stats. The attack stats are really nice, even for an LR. Max base dupe system are HP of 15,713, attack of 18,295, and defense of 12,400. And if you decide, if you get lucky or if you're well, you can get him all the way unlocked, and his max dupe system is going to be HP of 19,113, attack of 21,295, and defense of a flat out 15,000. The details of the card. Maximum super attack level is 20, which increases the super attack multiplier by an additional 30%. Greatly raises attack for one turn is a 50% attack damage multiplier, which is awesome. That's ridiculous. His additional 30% is calculated separately for a total boost of attack plus 121%, so that's really still nice. when performing an ultimate super attack, slightly higher if flat boosts from Link's skills are also factored in. So because you're going to get the 15%, it's going to take into effect after the 15%, which means he's going to do more damage. Support units' passive skills would be added to the initial calculation of attack plus 70%, meaning they'll also benefit the additional attack buff. 12 key multiplier is 150%, 24 key is 200%. So he is going to be doing a lot of damage if you super attack 20 him. Now, if I was to pull him, I definitely would. Elder Kai the crap out of him. That's my thing. I love Bardock's character. I think his whole character idea, who he was. I mean, I understand that the Bardock special is not canon, but Toriyama even gave a nod to it. At least shout out to Geekdom because I watched his video about that. And it's pretty epic. I really like the card. On Global side, I really hope I pull him. I will not be hunting, but I really hope I do pull him when it comes out because I will be doing some summons. Anyway, Saiyan Pride. Let's go ahead and talk about that. In terms of Saiyan Pride, the only other LR with Saiyan Pride is Majin Vegeta. Now, the good thing about that is Majin Vegeta's card, the only other attack link that he has is Super Saiyan, in terms of percentage boosts. Everything else is just key, and Saiyan Warrior Ace. So he actually has Saiyan Warrior Ace as well. So he essentially will hit, these two will hit off each of each other's link skills, everything except for Super Saiyan for Majin Vegeta. But the thing is, you have to take into consideration, you're going to run them two on the same team when you're doing a pure Saiyan team, if you have all of them. And when you're running a pure Saiyan's team, pretty much every Saiyan that you're going to run on that team is going to be a Super Saiyan. But we're going to talk about that in a bit. So you could actually get away with doing that, and Majin Vegeta will still get his actual Super Saiyan link off for 10%, and then they will link very well together. In terms of other units, the other ones with Saiyan Pride, for TUR is going to be the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. You have the Saiyan's little last stand Bardock, which is over here. I think that's his TUR variant. Yeah, that is not his TUR variant. This is the World Tournament guy. So you can run him, I guess, as a support unit. That would be pretty good because you get key plus. Oh, actually, he does because he doesn't do physical. That's all he would give him. So you don't even want to run him on the same team. What am I talking about here? I guess the other Bardocks, the two Bardocks over here, Kaba would have it. The Tech Majin Vegeta has it. Intelligence Bardock has it. Intelligence Vegeta has it. Barlot, Fasha, Super Strength Bardock, Physical Bardock, which is going to be one of his primary guys. Obviously, his other variant, which you can't link with him. One other one to mention, which will not show up on the TUR guide, is Borges or Borges. His Borgos. He has Saiyan Pride, so you can keep that in mind when talking about team building if you happen to have that. The OG Prince Vegeta or King Vegeta has it. And the new Majin Vegeta is obviously Majin Vegeta has it. I already talked about the other two. The physical and the agility ones also have it. So there you go. That's pretty much it, though. I mean, there's a lot. Essentially, it's all Vegetas and the OG low-class warriors, pretty much. But we're going to talk about the rest of those as well. In terms of best linking buddies in-game, let's go over to switch over to my Dokkan Battle Builder view. We have the Intelligence Bardock is going to be the best linking buddy. That's the World Tournament Bardock. He shares Battle Ethic Saiyan or Saiyan Warrior Race, Team Bardock, Key Plus 1, Saiyan Pride, Prepared for Battle, and Shattering the Limit. So that's 4-5 key total. So that's a total of 5 key, 700 attack buff, and 15%. He does have Super Saiyan, which will not be hit off, but depending on the team you're running, you can get away with that. This will be your best linking buddy on a mono pure Saiyan team to run alongside of him. The other one is going to be the other Bardock, the Great Ape Bardock. 5 link skills. Essentially, it's the same exact thing except for he gets Saiyan Blood instead of Prepared for Battle. So he loses 1 key, which that actually might come into play. Might be a little bit better depending on how much key you actually get from your support units that you're running. Because remember, you want him to have 17 key. You don't want him to go over 17. For the most damage output that you can do. But both of these guys are really good units. If you're lucky enough to have the LRs, the other two for pure Saiyan category, and this is not a pure Saiyan category team, by the way, it just happens that his best linking buddies are all pure Saiyans. LR Broly and LR Majin Vegeta. For the LR Broly, we already talked about Majin Vegeta, but for the LR Broly, Battle Ethic Saiyan, Saiyan Blood, Prepared for Battle, and Legendary Power. And same thing for Vegeta, as we talked about before. He does have that Saiyan Pride, Battle Ethic Saiyan, Shattering Limit, and Legendary Power. So he gets key, nice buffs and everything, so he will actually give him the best attack buff damage in the game, for Lynx anyway. And what else do we have over here? You have the low-class warrior Raditz, who gives him 5 key attack plus 700%, which is kind of over 700% wish, right? Attack plus 700. Doesn't really do too much. Bar a lot, which you can run on the team with him. Maybe not a pure Saiyans team, but you can definitely run the two of them together. Three key, Saiyan Pride, and Battle Ethic Saiyan, which isn't bad. And Fasha, so you could throw him alongside Fasha, Battle Ethic Saiyan, Team Bardock, Saiyan Pride, and Shattering the Limit, so three key, 15%, and 700. Again, honestly, the top ones over here, and obviously it's going to be the ones that are harder to get. I think the Great Ape of Bardock is probably going to be the easiest one out of all of these to get, because remember, these two are LRs, they have very, very low rates. This one is going to be a World Tournament exclusive, so you can only get them when the World Tournament comes around, and it's very limited on how you can get them. So, honestly, they're not bad units. None of these are bad units by any means whatsoever. It's just that you're probably only, for those of you who are not like, who haven't been playing hardcore or are not whales, the only time you're really going to have a chance to run it is if you're going to get the Tech Bardock. He's also usually featured on the Tech banners. His attack is going to be attack plus 100% when HP is 30% or above, so that's definitely really cool. Outside of that, I mean, you will not be getting Saiyan Roar, which is kind of sucks. Saiyan Roar is a 25% attack buff, which the Great Ape Bardock does have. Outside of that, everything else on him is keylink, so you're not going to do that bad, but just remember, he is going to be really meant for the LR Bardock, that's about it. In terms of mono physical team for four or more, you have two SSRs, actually. It's kind of funny, because when this Bardock over here, Dokken Awakens, he Dokken Awakens to a TUR, but he loses, I believe it's Saiyan Warrior Race. I think it's actually Prepared for Battle, but either way, he loses one of his link skills. Actually, it's Saiyan Warrior Race. So he does not show up as four or more when he uses a TUR. So these are the only two on the mono physical super team for four or more link skills. We can go over here, we will take off the SSRs, we'll drop it down to three. For mono physical team, this is who he has. You have LR Trunks over here, you have Super Saiyan Goku from the Korra event. OG Vegeta, I think he is the debuffer, right? Let's see. Attack 40% down of the attacked enemy, so he reduces the enemy's attack by 40% when he attacks them. The TUR Bardock, which I was telling you about how he drops one. I think it's Saiyan Warrior Race. Yes, he drops Saiyan Warrior Race. This Goku, Super Saiyan 2 Goku, allies, key plus 2, attack plus 20% up. So he's pretty good to run alongside of him. He does 4 key, so he might do good because his passive will do 6 key plus some attack buffs. He doesn't have Saiyan Pride though, which kind of sucks. You have the TUR Broly, which is 3 key, attack plus 700. This Goku over here, the one from Bubbles, is really nothing, just key links. You have the Gohan over here, the LR Gohan from Super Battle Road, for 700 attack buff, Saiyan Blood, which is one key in Legendary Power. He really sucks for linking, buddy. And Kale for three links, Saiyan Blood and four key, Prepared for Battle, Shattering Limit. Honestly, I'm probably going to say that all these kind of suck. I think the Bardock over here is the only one for, because he has Saiyan Pride. So I think this Bardock is going to be the only one that I like. Actually, I think this, does this Vegeta have Saiyan Pride? I forgot. No, he doesn't. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That Bardock's going to be the best mono-physical person you can link with him, other than the Borgos. And Borgos, yeah, he really isn't that great of a unit. The thing is, it's really cool about this Bardock on top of that. When HP is 30% or above, all of your allies get key plus 2 and attack plus 20%. So he's going to be giving him additional key as well and the attack buff. Remember also LR Trunks, while he doesn't have Saiyan Pride, he's another LR, so they will do some decent damage together. It's up to you if you want to run the two, if you even have the two. It's very difficult to actually get a multiple LRs on one team, unless you're like wailing out in the game. So the Intelligence Bardock's best linking buddy overall in game for him, or the Great Ape base form Bardock. But in terms of mono physical, the other Bardock, the Super Saiyan Bardock here, is probably going to be one of his best linking buddies, because he gives him his only attack, really good attack buff, and he gives him 3 key. Plus the 2 key on his passive. So yeah, I'm going to say that for best linking buddy, you're going to want to run alongside him. Next one is going to be the Low Class Warrior. Now, it's actually funny, because Low Class Warrior and Saiyan are pretty much the same exact teams, or same exact linking buddies. As I said, the Great Ape Bardock is going to be his best linking buddy. You have Fasha and Raditz, which we already talked about. You have the World Tournament Turles for three link skills, which is 4 key, attack plus 700%. The OG Intelligence Turles, which is 4 key, 700 attack. I think I said 700% again. Stop saying 700%, Delconic. 3 key for the Goku, or 3 links with the Goku for 5 key total. And the Strength Great Ape Raditz, which is still a whack unit in my opinion, for 3 key and 700 attack buff. So that's really it. If you go over here, it's pretty much the damn same thing, except you have Super Saiyan Bardock, the 5 key one. This is for a pure Saiyans team, by the way. So honestly, a pure Saiyans team, I mean, I'm going to say this. We already talked about Fasha. We already talked about Raditz. I don't like these two at all. These two are not going to be even considered unless you really have nothing else. These are going to be the four cards that you're going to really want to consider running on this team. Now, I personally think that these are really all phenomenal units that you're going to want to run. Bardock, the base form Bardock is going to hit off a lot of his link skills. 4 key total, 15%, and a 700 attack buff. This guy is going to be 5 key total, 15%, and a 700 attack buff. You really can't go wrong with either of these two. They pretty much, actually, I think, I'm pretty sure they hit off... Yeah, they hit off the same exact thing, except one less key with the actual tech one. Tech one's going to do more damage. The intelligence one is going to do... key plus 3, attack plus 7,000. So, honestly, you're probably going to be better off going with the tech Bardock. Just remember that the intelligence one seals. So it's up to you on how you actually want to run it. The two of them will seal together, but remember, if you're not going for 18 key, you're going to at least be able to seal with the intelligence one. You'll do less damage. Up to you on how you want to run it. They both do supreme damage. The tech one's definitely going to out-damage the intelligence one. And the tech one is easier to get dupes of. And the other thing is, though, I guess he's semi-farmable because you could pull Super Saiyan Bardock over here for the intelligence one. It's really a toss in the air between the two of them. Just go with whichever one you have. If I had to pick one, I would probably go with a tech grade 8 Bardock. Then again, he has the grade 8 mechanic, which means he'll transform, and I hate having that rotation screwed up. I guess it would depend on the opponent I'm going up against. If I'm going up an opponent which has more tech stages, I'll probably bring the intelligence one. If they're more agility stages, I'll bring the tech grade 8 Bardock. In terms of these two, if you have either of these two, just run them on your team. That's probably going to be my best bet for you, or what I'm going to say to you for a actual Saiyan team. They're both really awesome. They're not going to go well on a Heroes team because obviously they're not Heroes. So it's up to you on what else you want to run it, but on a pure Saiyan team, if you have these two, definitely run them alongside of him. I'll go with Majin Vegeta next to him over anyone else, or over the Broly anyway, just because he has Saiyan Pride 2 key and all the other attack buffs. In terms of a monophysical building team, or team building, there's a lot of units over here. Now, I brought all the units out that have Saiyan Pride, just so that way you know for a monophysical team that you could run. You have the Bardock over here, which we already talked about. He will give him additional 20% attack buff plus his Saiyan Pride, which is awesome. You just need to keep your HP above 30%. We talked about Borghost. Borghost has 4 link skills with him. Borghos has Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Blood, Team Bardock, and Saiyan Pride. So 2 key, 15%, and a 700 flat-out buff. Personally, I would not run him on a team. He is just there. I'm going to take him off of the actual team building guide over here. I just wanted you all to be aware that he is there to choose. You also have this Majin Vegeta. He is an extreme type. Both of these Vegetas are actually extreme types. They're not going to get the full buff that the other super units are going to get, but they have Saiyan Pride. So this Vegeta over here, let's see. I actually have him up over here because I want to be able to give you the English translation. He is defense plus 30% with every attack performed, up to 120%, so he's going to tank a lot, and attack plus 30% for every attack received, up to 90%. So I would go full additional on this guy because he's going to get his defensive buff stat up really fast. If you are looking to make sure, like, put these two together, the other one is going to be this Vegeta over here, which is Fiery Pride Vegeta. Attacking defense plus 70% when performing a super attack. HP is 50% or below. He gets an additional key plus 5 defense plus 50%. So he's pretty much always going to get super attacks off. So I'm going to take him off, and I'm just going to say this is a viable choice. This Trunks does not have Saiyan Pride, but I think it was just worth mentioning that I would run him on a team if I had him. So honestly, it's really going to come down to these two, who you're going to run on a team. I would probably run the two of them alongside your Bardock. So I actually go over here and grab the other Bardock just so we could throw him on there, just so we could have like a little bit of proof of concept over here of how we're going to run it. So this is how I would probably run it for fun. And then I would have my Weirus and Kel, because they are both key orb manipulators. Then whoever else you want to throw there, 17 is a key orb manipulator. If you want to throw someone else, this Vegeta is just to get his super attack off. This is obviously a team focused on Bardock. You could obviously put Bardock on rotation, take this Vegeta out, and throw whatever combination that you want into this. I mean, personally, I would probably, in terms of super, let's see, you could throw, let me switch back over to my Chrome view so you can see what I'm doing over here. I mean, you have Super Vegeta over here, and you have, boom, You have Super Vegito, you have Gotenks with Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks you can run. You have Trunks, which is a really good attack. You have LR Majin, or LR Vegeta and Goku, the Angel. You have the, well, this is actually a really good support unit. you have the Trunks over here, who is a good support unit that you could run. You have Vegito Blue. There was another Gohan. It was the one, this one over here, who has a nice attack buff. So you have a lot of different choices for who else you want to run. But again, I was basing it off of the LR Bardock. This isn't what I'm going to run, and I would definitely have the Keyword Manipulators because you're going to run the LRs. Especially if you're going to run that LR Trunks, you're definitely going to want to have that additional, those additional key orbs coming in. So that way you can get off your 17 and 18 key. Plus, also, if you take into consideration the fact that you have four LRs total on Mono Physical Super, yeah, you definitely want those key orbs. But anyway, guys, that's it for the LR Bardock. I'm super hyped for it. I really hope I get him when he comes around to the global side. If I don't, oh well, again, I'm not hunting him. LR Gohan was the only one I hunted. I just like LR Bardock, but he's not, he doesn't meet the requirements of what I would want of like a ridiculously OP unit. But then again, I actually haven't watched gameplay yet. So I'm pretty sure with his passive and the links and everything you could do with him, he could probably hit for over 3 to 4 million damage. But anyway, guys, that is it. Thank you for joining me here today. I hope that was helpful and informative. Let me know what you guys think of the teams and the team building down in the comments below, and I'll catch you all down there. Peace out.